गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम टू टुडेज क्लास. टुडे फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंडिकेटर्स एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मेटल एक्टिविटी सीरीज. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ इंडिकेटर्स. इंडिकेटर्स आर सम ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेज विच विल शो सम डेफिनेट कलर्स, डिफरेंट कलर्स दे विल शो इन एसिड एंड बेसिक मीडियम. Okay, so and by this color we can understand that whether this solution is acidic or basic. So these are the main function of indicators. By changing their colors or by showing a specific color, they can indicate the nature of the solution, whether it is basic or acidic or neutral. Okay. So first of all, litmus. In acid medium, litmus is red, and in basic medium, litmus is blue. So if you dip a blue litmus, in a acid solution, then it will convert to red. And if we dip our red litmus in a basic solution, then it will convert to blue. Okay, it will change its color to blue. So red litmus in basic solution, it will convert to red to blue, this coloration. And if we dip our blue litmus in an acid solution, then it will change its color from blue to red. So from this we can understand that whether this solution is acidic or basic. Next comes to methyl orange. Methyl orange, this is another indicator which will show in acid medium, this will show red or rosy pink color. Red or pink, we can say. This pink is rosy pink, okay, and in a basic medium it will show yellow color. Methyl orange, its original color is orange, okay. So it's if it is neutral, its color will be orange. When we will add few drops of methyl orange in acid medium, then it will change its color from orange to red or pink or rosy pink. Or if we add it in basic medium, if we add few drops of methyl orange in a basic medium like in sodium hydroxide or in ammonium hydroxide, then from orange to yellow this coloration we can see, we can observe. So it will change its color from orange to yellow in basic medium. Next comes phenolphthalein, which already we have done in an activity in the last video class. Phenolphthalein. In acid medium, this is colorless. No color is there. But in basic medium, it is violet or pink. Okay, deep pink we can say. So if we add phenolphthalein in acid medium, then it will not show any color, it will be colorless only. But if we add it in basic medium, then it will show its color from colorless to pink. Okay, so these are the main three indicators which are there in the syllabus. Now let us get the importance of indicators in our daily life. Also we are having few these indicators can play a very vital role. The chemicals which we are using means this basic and acid with basic and acid medium, we are the chemicals which we are using, or in our body the chemicals which will produce, these are acidic or basic. Okay, neutral solutions are also there, neutral substances are also there. So to neutralize that, we can use different chemicals. Okay, to neutralize those, the medicines which we are taking or the cosmetics or different daily life products which we are using, that is because of that. Okay, now first of all, indigestion. If we have indigestion, then that means excess acid will be acid is released from our stomach or intestine and all. So to neutralize the acid, acha, let me write down the points. So here we are going to discuss importance of indicators. Number one, indigestion. Indigestion. If we have indigestion, that means excess acid will be produced. Then to neutralize that, we generally take some medicines which is having some bases. Okay, that means the acid, if we have acidity, actually the acid will be neutralized by some medicines which are basic in nature. So those are like antacids. These we are calling as antacids. That means antacids, which will neutralize the acid, and these are basic in nature. These antacids are basic in nature. Magnesium hydroxide. This is a well known antacid which we take. This is called milk of magnesia. Okay, this is magnesium hydroxide. This is called milk of magnesia. So in this manner, we can neutralize the acid produced in our stomach. Next, number two, that is oral hygiene. We can say because of this acid, this acid may produce in our mouth also, because of as we are taking food, and there are some bacteria also which will produce this acid in our mouth. Now to we do brush every day just to remove neutralize the acid produced in our mouth. We use toothpaste. We use toothpaste, which is basic in nature. Okay, so by using or by brushing our teeth with toothpaste, we can actually we are neutralizing the acid which is produced in our mouth. Okay, next, number three, insect sting. So there are some insect which because of the bite of those insect, we can they will just add some acid or in the sting there are some acid which will because of the bite of those insect, they will just add that acid into our body. Now to remove that, now to neutralize that, we have to we generally use some basic substances which will neutralize this. So this is another importance of the neutralization reaction in our life. Now to neutralize the acid from insect sting, we can use some lotion, calamine lotion, which is again basic in nature. This is acidic. Now to neutralize this, we have to use some substances or medicine which are basic in solutions. For that we can use calamine lotion. Calamine lotion or select lime we can use, or baking soda also can be used to neutralize this. Next, this bitter, we can say importance of neutralization reaction. This is the importance of neutralization reaction in our daily life, we can say. Okay, this is not importance of indicators, this is neutralization reactions and their importance. Next, number 4, soil treatment. So to grow the plant or to grow different crops and all, we need a particular pH of the soil. Okay, for different plants we need a different kind of soil, or different pH of the soil should be maintained to get the proper growth of that plant. Now to after getting the crop, when again we need to plant the again for the new season, when we want to plant the crop again, then before in between the time we must treat the soil, we must get the pH value of the soil, whether it is proper for that particular plant or not, and then we need to treat it. If it is not proper, then we have to use some fertilizers which will keep the soil, which will maintain the pH value of the soil, and in this manner we do the soil treatment to get the proper growth of the plant. Okay, so this is also we can say the importance of the neutralization reaction. Okay, so these are the 4 points. First of all, indigestion, which will the acids produced in our stomach, that will be neutralized by the basic medicines. Next, oral hygiene. The reason why we are using the toothpaste and why it contain basic substances. Next, insect sting, by which we can remove or we can neutralize the acidic substance which is given by the insect sting by some basic this also we can call as medicines. Okay, some basic medicines or basic chemicals like select lime or calamine lotion or like baking soda. Okay, and next, soil treatment to get the proper growth of the plant. So these 4 were the importance of neutralization reaction. Next, we will be now let us get the metal activity series. This is just today I will be telling you only the metals or the what is the activity series, and then in our next class we are going we will go for the detailed discussion of this. Okay, now metal activity series is a metal activity series is such a series or a list of the metals, we can say, which are listed in such a manner that the maximum active metal is kept at the top, and accordingly its activity will decrease. Okay, so at first the top we are having potassium, which is having the highest activity in the metal activity series. Okay, after potassium comes sodium. Next comes calcium. Okay, we know potassium, sodium, these are very much active metal. Calcium is also very, very active. Next comes magnesium, aluminium, then zinc, iron. Next comes lead. Then we are having hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen also we are keeping in this activity series only, and from hydrogen only we can compare whether the metal is more active than the hydrogen or it is less active than hydrogen. So these metals, all these metals which are above hydrogen, that means these are more active than hydrogen. Now after hydrogen we are having copper, mercury. Okay, acha, after hydrogen the metals which are there, that I am writing this side. So we are having copper, mercury, then we are having silver, Ag, gold, then platinum. Okay, so potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron. Then we are having lead, then hydrogen, copper, then copper, after hydrogen we are having copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. That means these metals are less active than hydrogen. So why this activity series is so important? Because if we react any substance, if we react any during the reaction of different metals or the compounds of metals, whether the metal can react, whether the two substances can react, and what will be the product of the reaction, that we can predict from this metal activity series. So the substances which are above the, suppose if we compare between hydrogen and aluminium or hydrogen and zinc, if both these two are there, then as zinc is more active than hydrogen, so it can remove hydrogen from its compound and it can take its place. So we can get the hydrogen gas. So, and that's why we are having this reaction, zinc plus HCl. See, this is a substance, this is a compound of hydrogen. So as hydrogen is less reactive than zinc, so the tendency of the more active substances is to form the ion. So here zinc is at it's not forming any ion, it is in metallic form. So zinc's tendency is from this to this. Okay, zinc to zinc ion. That's why this will react with HCl and it will remove hydrogen from its compound to produce zinc chloride, and along with hydrogen gas will evolve. Okay, so this reaction can happen. This reaction can happen, but if we, instead of zinc, if we take copper, then as copper is less reactive than hydrogen, so this reaction is not possible. So this reaction, copper plus HCl, we cannot get CuCl2 plus hydrogen. This reaction is not possible because copper is less reactive than hydrogen. Okay, so this is the importance of metal activity series. So today up to this only. Next day we will be discussing the more important, the other importance of this metal activity series and all. Okay, till then you just keep studying. Take care.